Amazon is getting into video, and while there are so many articles and people talking about how this is going to be a huge game changer, the most important thing for video creators like you and me is to know exactly how we can actually get our videos on Amazon's new platform, Video Direct. So in this video, I'm going to show you the step-by-step process that I've been using to upload as much content to Amazon right now. Because if we can get our films and videos up there before everyone else, we have a great chance of standing out and having a ton of success. So let's dive into uploading our videos on Amazon Video Direct. The first thing you need to do is sign up for an account. Go to videodirect.amazon.com, create your free account, and log in with your Amazon credentials or create a new account. Once you log in, you're going to go to your dashboard that looks like this. It will seem like you don't have any videos or views because you don't have any videos up. There are a couple tabs at the top, and so you're going to want to click your videos. Right now, I've uploaded 5 different videos. I'm seeing the different things that Amazon Video Direct is looking at, different file types, different types of images, different video descriptions, and exactly what works for getting your videos published to Amazon. Right now, you can see that one of my videos has been published on all of these platforms, Japan, the UK, Amazon.com, and Germany's Amazon. And so if you search for edit documentary, you can see the first result is my video, how to edit a documentary. How awesome is that? That's along with all the other results, the books, the products that Amazon has. So how do you upload your own video? Click add title right here. From here, you're going to want to write in the title of your video, choose a category. For here, they have a bunch of different categories. Just pick one of these that works best for you, and then choose your catalog listing language. Then click continue. You'll be taken to a page like this that has the catalog listing. This is where you have the title of your video, the category, which have already been plugged in. Then you write out a synopsis, which is a 400 character description of your video. Below that, you have your genres, and so you can choose up to 5 genres. They have predetermined genres. Just start typing in keywords that you think might be related to your video, and then click the category or genre that you think fits best. I would suggest using as many of these as possible. Below that, you choose your rating. If you have an actual rating for your film, most of us for our videos, if we're taking them from YouTube or just creating them ourselves, they will be not rated. Suggested rating, you can choose what you think. Of course, you want to be honest about this because you don't want to have this negative affect you. If you have cussing or something in your video, you want to make sure that it's an age-appropriate rating. Then you choose the original language of your film. And if you have an original release date, you can choose that. I've left that out for both of these for all my videos. Below are your graphic assets. So this is the key art that will be shown in the search results and all sorts of places for your videos when people are searching for it. So you have a 16x9 title card, and what you need to do, you can click on these little eye buttons to get more information. This image is a 1920x1080 pixel file, JPEG or PNG. This other image is 1200x1600 pixels, and again, JPEG or PNG. And then here is a background image. So this can be one that will show on the detail screens of your when your search results are showing up, and it just gives an overall vibe for your video. So to create your title cards and images, use a program like Photoshop, and you're going to just have to create a new project with the correct width and height for both of those. So for, again, the main key art, it's 1920x1080. For the background detail, it's 1920x1080. And then for that up and down key art, it's 1200x1600. And you can see this key art right here. That's the one that's going to show up on this page. So make sure that it's relevant. If you can have text that explains what your video is all about, that will help as well. Use the same type of techniques you use with your YouTube videos to create eye-catching thumbnails. So once you have that art, click browse, and that will take you to your file uploader and choose your file, and then click save. It's going to take a few moments to save, and just wait until the catalog listing text up here becomes green. And then you want to move on to these next tabs. So for cast and crew, they're looking at you as an actual video producer, video creator. So if you just want to put your name, you can do that. I have a business, so I've put my business name up here for Studio Creator. And then down below, I have my crew and cast, which again is just me. So I put my name under crew, the role of producer. And for cast, again, my name. And since I'm an instructor in these videos, I put instructor. You can add cast members and crew members by clicking these buttons and adding more. Then click save and move along to your next tab. So the mezzanine file, this is your actual video. Now there are some rules and regulations for what quality you have to upload, but for now, 1920 by 1080p is the right format. It needs to be that high of a quality to fulfill their publishing requirements and so that you can get paid for it using putting it on Amazon Prime or streaming it with ads. 4K and Ultra HD video is not accepted at this time, and lower video 1280 by 720 is not either. So once you click browse, this little language button will pop up. So again, click the language of your video. And then your captions. So you're going to have to add captions for your videos. That's one of the requirements that they give you. I'm going to show you an easy way to get your captions for your videos. Most of you will be taking videos that you've already published on YouTube and putting them on Amazon Video Direct. YouTube has a captioning system that tries to add automatic closed captions to your videos. So if you go to one of your videos after you've uploaded it, and it might take a little while to actually produce these subtitles, but go to your video information page or the video editor and click this subtitles and closed captions button. You'll see here that it has an English automatic subtitle added. So click that. To the right, you can see that it has this actions. Click actions and download one of these versions. I would suggest choosing the .srt version. That will download this closed captioning that YouTube has automatically created. And you want to download it because not only are you going to have to upload it to Amazon, but you're going to want to edit it because these closed captions aren't perfect and Amazon is looking for great, perfect closed captioning. I'm on a Mac and you can see here that I've downloaded this captions.srt file. If I want to edit these, I can go right click, open with other, and then I can choose just something as simple as my text editor, text edit. If you're on a Windows, you're going to have to use whatever the internal Windows text editor is. From here, you can see that it's this file that has a bunch of numbers and text. You can kind of see how it works. Each of these blocks is a different block of closed captioning text that appears on your screen. So what I would do is just go through these and type in the right words. If things are misspelled, add punctuation where you need it. And then once you are done, you can just say save, and it's going to save it as that captions.srt file. Okay, so once you have downloaded your closed captioning and edited them, go back to your Amazon upload page and click this browse button and add those captions. You're going to choose the frame rate and the language. So YouTube videos are 29.97 frames per second, so choose that. And language, of course, you want to choose whatever language you have. If you have a trailer, you can upload that as well, but you don't need to. For a lot of us, we're not going to have trailers for our videos that we put on YouTube, but if you do have a film, a short film, a longer film, you can add that as well. Click save and then move on to availability. So most of us, we want to put this worldwide, so you can choose worldwide. If you only want it to be in specific countries, you can do that. And then how will Amazon customers watch this video? That's the next option. So you have the option to include it with Amazon Prime, so anyone that has an Amazon Prime membership can watch it, or you can make it free with pre-roll ads. And this is in the US, and this is great for short form titles because no one's going to want to rent or buy your 2-minute YouTube video for the prices that it costs. unless you have a huge following and you think that people will actually pay a few bucks for your video, then I wouldn't do this rent or buy option right now. If you have a longer film or a short film, yeah, maybe this is a good option. But for those of us just taking our YouTube videos and putting them on Amazon, just include them with Prime and use this free with pre-roll ad, which is similar to how it works on YouTube. But if you do want to choose rent, you can choose the option whether you want the base price or the value price. So they have two tiers. And then same with the buy price. You have the base and the value. The last option is when should this video be available? You should click as soon as possible unless you want to publish it later at a later date. Right now, Amazon will do its best to honor the requested future start date. But for most of us, we're just going to publish it as soon as possible. Then click save. And once all these things are green, this little publish button up here on the top right will appear and you can click that. I forgot to mention though, once you have your video assets page all set up and you click save, it will upload your video. So it will take a few minutes or however long, depending on how long your video is. So after you do that, everything's green, hit the publish button and you're good to go. You can go back to your videos page. For me, I've come into a couple errors that I'm trying to figure out why a certain video was accepted, why a certain video was not. It will show you the details if you click this view details if it hasn't been accepted. For example, this video has an error because it's a .mov file, but apparently it wasn't ProRes 422 HQ video codec. So I'm gonna have to go back and re-export my videos with that codec. So we're still kind of figuring out how this is going to work, but hopefully this has helped you. And again, it's amazing how relatively quickly my videos are showing up in the results for Amazon. So get to it. I would honestly spend the next few days or a little bit of time each day uploading videos to Amazon Video Direct, because if we can be at the start of this huge movement towards putting videos on Amazon, we could have a lot of success and ultimately make a lot of money. Amazon tends to do things the right way, and I'm sure that this is going to be huge for video creators as well. Thanks for watching, and if you have any questions, let me know. Otherwise, we'll see you in another video.